Hey, g'day. Today, got a bit of a big news for us. There'll be a new addition to Camping Mate's channel. We're at Sutherland Mazda, and I'm gonna show you around. Now, need to give a bit of a credit for the boys, Travis, Raj, and Conrad. Thanks, boys. Thanks for looking after me. And let's go and see the beast. Now, when you get a new car, there is a couple of things that you have to do as rituals. For me, the first one is give a bit of a kiss to the steering wheel and say, all right, we gotta trust each other for next coming couple of years. So I'm gonna get into that real quickly so you guys can look away for a bit.
A few moments later.
So number two is get rid of the all the new car smell, because apparently, according to Elon Musk, lawsuit, new car smell can be quite dangerous. So for that, we're gonna use all these stuff. This is sex wax, beautiful stuff as car air fresheners. So I'm gonna do that as ritual number two. Boom, there you go. As ritual number three, I'm gonna fly the double flags. Back in the days, people used to go to these sacred places and get a bit of a blessing for the car and yourself. I don't really have to worry about that on road because there is a plethora of safety features just built into this particular car, so I'm cool with that. But when it's come to off-road, I need a bit of a blessing when I'm driving all those beaten tracks. So looking after myself, my car, and surrounding, I have to give that responsibility to someone who I can trust, none other than Russell Coit. So he's gonna look after both of us and the road and everything when we're out in the bush. As ritual four, I'm gonna hang Russell Coit's face just right up here for a bit of a good luck charm. Now you know what sort of car I got, and let's talk about the car itself. Officially, christening is over. Let's get to it. Now, this is a Mazda BT50, as you can tell, in indigo silver. I reckon that's the color it is. If not, I'm gonna put that on the screen. So, this is the car I choose to go with. It's a bit of a surprise for myself as well. There is a couple of different reasons that I didn't really go with the Hilux, the Ranger, MUX, or Nissan Navara, or Triton. I'll go through them real quickly, and then let's talk about this particular vehicle that's gonna be next phase of Camping Mate's channel. You might ask, why not the Hilux? It is, for one, exuberantly priced, and the second is, when I'll check last time, weight was 777 months. Ford Ranger, again, exuberantly priced, $70,000 or more, $75,000 for a wild track. Again, ridiculously expensive. And the D-Max is, again, not that expensive, but the wait time is, again, through the roof, around 757 months. And then again, you have Navara and the Triton. Both of them, they were out because they're missing one significant feature that I was looking for, which is radar cruise control. If you ever used one, you're probably addicted to it. But that's what happened to me with my previous car. I had a Padge 2020, and that car had a beautiful radar cruise control system because I spent a fair bit of a time on the road. If I can get any help from the car, any aid from the car to make that experience better, I'm gonna jump on it. So that's where the BT50 and D-Max came to play, because those are the two utes in the market. A bit sensible in terms of price and very sensible in terms of safety. So this particular car has 5-star safety system, which is fantastic, and 8 airbags. So those are the things that my purchase based on the price and the safety and some features that I really liked. And one of the other features that I really wanted in a ute was a rear diff lock. This baby has it, so I reckon money well spent as far as I'm concerned. If you have any thoughts, just let me know down in the comment below, and yeah, see how we go. When I make up those arbitrary numbers, 470 months wait, 340 months wait, those are not true. But long story short, you have to wait a fair amount of time to get if you're getting a four-wheel drive ute. So from Ford Ranger, Hilux, and the MU D-Max LSU, they all have more than 12 months wait. And that's one of the other reasons that I choose this car, because they had it in stock with everything installed. Now, this is not from premium class as far as I'm concerned, because it's a bit of a budget sort of a ute, because it's lying around mid 50s to early 60s. So this particular version is Mazda BT50 XT. So this is, I reckon this is the lower end of the range. And when I got the car, they had everything sort of installed in. So this is a demo version to 2022. I'm not really sure whether I have all those updated stuff from 2023, no clue. If it's there, it's fantastic. If it's not there, couldn't care less. Now, you might ask, the OEM bull buy, is that worth it? Honestly, I don't really care, couldn't care less. And the second question you're probably gonna ask, will that be winch compatible? Come again? And the third question you might ask, hey, Dre, is that, can you add a recovery points to it? What's that again? Now, as the fourth question you might ask, can you attach a UHF antenna to it without doing any modification? We don't communicate with other people. We're long wolves. Look, long story short, no. The answer is no. You're not gonna get winch compatibility. You can't fit a UHF antenna because there is no attachment point to it. There is only two attachment points for this light bar, and that's about it. And no winch, no recovery points for this particular bull bar as far as I'm concerned. It's a bit of a detriment, to be honest. I wouldn't enjoy that. If I do it again, I would do it without a bull bar and get aftermarket bull bar and a winch and the recovery points. But long story short, I wouldn't do much four-wheel driving in this car. I mainly do camping, touring, and cooking. Read that here. There you go. Not a massive detriment, not a deal breaker as far as I'm concerned. So that's a bit of a drawback of this bull bar, but I reckon that's looks bloody cool. Now, in front of the car, we have beautiful dual row light force light bar. I haven't tested it out yet. I'm pretty keen to give it a go maybe tonight. And light force being sort of Australian business and all these lights made in Australia, which is, I'm pretty proud to have something like that stuck in front of my car, something I can trust regardless of the conditions. And then moving a bit backwards, I have a bonnet protector. So this is made out of vibranium, if you know what I'm talking about, and this will protect the entire car. People, the last bit is a bit of a sarcasm. and then we're gonna go a bit backwards towards the roof. On the roof, we got a set of genuine Mazda roof bars. So I'm not really sure about what's the roof capacity of these systems, but I don't really have anything that I'm gonna put on the roof straight away. I have to wait and configure this blank canvas moving forward. Not really sure what I'm gonna do with it, but it's there. Speaking of other genuine accessories, I went ahead and opted out for a tub liner. I don't know why I did that. I might not gonna keep the tub for long. Maybe I'll put a canopy on it. Maybe not, I'm not really sure. But opted out and got a tub liner, which is pretty nice and pretty happy with it at the moment. And come around. Now, around the back, we have a 3.5 ton towing capacity tow bar factory fitted in. What that means is, since I don't have recovery points in the front, this could be a recovery point, or when I need it, I can tow a caravan or camp trailer, which is fantastic in my opinion. And this particular unit has that class leading 3.5 ton towing capacity. without putting any GVM upgrade, nothing on it, which is fantastic in my books. This bad boy has 17-inch alloy wheels and it's wrapped around Dunlop Grand Trek 8025. So it's sort of a moderate all-terrain tire. I wouldn't call it all-terrain. And then you have disc brakes in the front, but from 1945, they've got drum brakes in the back, which is not acceptable, but what can I do? I can't really go and put disc brake into it. So gotta deal with it, I guess. Now the interior is pretty basic and we have cloth seats all around and we have sort of a carpet that given from the dealer, but underneath it has, what do you call them? Vinyl flooring, fantastic. So it's Scouts, cleaning up is gonna be pretty easy. And yeah, steering wheel is plastic wrapped, so not the leather, but better. And you got, switches, couple of blank ones that I'm gonna put some stuff to it pretty soon. And got a wireless Apple CarPlay. How good is that? Wireless Apple CarPlay. Nice. And a few nice touches here and there. Nothing exuberant or extraordinary. And I'm not expecting any of those in a lower end ute, but it's practical. It will serve me purpose and it's gonna be new and great addition to the Camping Mates YouTube channel. Before we wrap this up, you might ask, Jay, how's the drive? Look, to be honest, I can't really give you too much opinion about this particular car because so I had it about a day and then this is the only ute I actually driven sort of extensively. So in my opinion, not gonna get counted as far as I'm concerned. So there is heaps of other different YouTubers out there who's doing full reviews and full comparison of other utes and this one. As far as I'm concerned, the ride is pretty bumpy as you would expect in any other ute. It's not a car or passenger focused vehicle. So as far as I'm concerned, I'm happy with it. And the other thing is steering wheel is amazing. It's electrically assisted steering wheel. Now, that experience is fantastic. It's drive like a car. It's amazing on the road when you're getting corners and stuff like that. It's pretty predictable and amazing. Now, if you got any questions, just let me know about this particular model, BT50, the one I've got, XT, I believe. So it's not the top of the range model. It's just more like below, down in the lower area sort of ute. So yeah, if you got any questions, just let me know. Follow us on Instagram, YouTube, click that bell icon, and then let me know, comment, like, and subscribe. There is heaps of different brand new content coming to the channel with BT50 and everything else, the camping, the ASMR videos, everything coming to the channel. So I reckon you should come along and you wouldn't be disappointed. See you around.